And welcome to another session of Answer the Community, where I answer more of your questions about the PolySync 40 speakerphones. Hi there, it's Rolando, and welcome to Answer the Community, where I answer your questions about headsets, speakerphones, and other office technology. Today, I continue answering your questions about the PolySync speakerphones, specifically the Sync 40 model. Before we get started, I want to remind you to go ahead and bump that like button so we can bring you more content like this. And now let's go ahead and dive into your questions. The first question that we've got here is, how many PolySync models are there? It's a good question. It's not an easy answer because it depends on your math, but let me give you the basics here. You have your entry-level model, which is your PolySync 20. And then above that, in a bigger form factor, you have your PolySync 40. And there's still yet another form factor that's larger than this one, and that's the PolySync 60. All of these different models come in the Microsoft Teams version, as well as the UC version, which stands for Unified Communication. Let me boil it down for you real simply. If you're a Microsoft Teams user, you'll enjoy and want to get the Microsoft Teams version. They come with an integrated button so you can more easily use Microsoft Teams. But if you're a Zoom user, you use Google Meet or other voice apps like Ring Central or Vonage, you'll want to get the UC version, which allows you to use it across the entire spectrum of apps that are out there. But guess what? You can use both of them, the UC or the Microsoft Teams version on any app. It's just that Microsoft version that's designed specifically for Teams and comes with a Teams button, but it will also work across all other apps. So yeah, you've got a couple of different versions depending on how and what kind of math you're using. Let's go into the next question. How do you pair the PolySync 40? This is probably one of the most popular questions out there. So let's start with first stating what we're going to pair it to. In this first example, I'm going to pair it to a mobile phone so you could see the sequence on the Sync 40 on how to do that. So let's take a look. So the first thing you want to do is make sure that your Sync 40 is already charged. Next, we'll want to put the Sync 40 into pairing mode. And on the Sync 40, you've got this button all the way on the left. We'll hold that down for 2 seconds.
Pairing.
Go ahead and grab your mobile device and put it into pairing mode. And you're gonna look for the PolySync 40. And once you've done that, you'll be able to get connected. So I'm gonna go to my mobile phone. I'm going to turn on the Bluetooth and I'm gonna look for the PolySync 40. And now that your mobile device has found the PolySync 40, now you're connected and you'll hear the word connected on your Sync 40 speakerphone. And now let's look at how to connect and pair your PolySync 40 to your PC Bluetooth dongle. And right here, I've got that dongle and I'm going to go ahead and plug that in into the PC. Next, we'll want to put the Sync 40 into pairing mode. We'll hold that down for 2 seconds.
Pairing.
Beautiful. Now, your dongle should connect and it should give us connected. In the event that it does not connect, what you'll want to use is your PolyLens app to go ahead and either update your Bluetooth dongle, or you'll want to hit the small round white button that is on the Bluetooth dongle. Let me show you what that looks like. I'm going to pull mine out of the PC so you can see what that looks like. All right, this is the dongle. And on this dongle, you have this white button. This white button, you hold that down for 3 seconds while this is inserted into your PC, and it will automatically light up and engage the dongle. It will light up red and blue for about 30 seconds. And then after that, it will go back and disable itself. So make sure you do that within the first 30 seconds. Okay, so I'm gonna try that on my end. And you should see here on the PolySync 40, we get a connection.
Pairing successful.
Awesome.
PC connected.
There you go. Pairing successful. That's what you wanna hear. And now you have successfully connected your PolySync 40 to your Bluetooth dongle on your PC. Here's a pro tip. If you want to have greater range, let's say I want to take this PolySync 40, and maybe I'm in a conference room that's a little bit big, and that laptop is hanging out at the other end of the conference room. You'll want to use the Bluetooth Blue Beacon range extender. Links are below where you can get this so that you have expanded coverage for your Bluetooth dongle in any environment that you're in. Next question is a very good question. It says, can I use more than one Sync 40 in the same conference room? Of course you can. On the Sync 40, you've got a dedicated button to do just that. Over here, you have power, and over here, you have this link button. What you'll want to do is hold that down for several seconds. And if you're using two of the Sync 40s, you can put that into pairing mode for the link, for the additional link.
Connecting.
And it'll say connecting. And it'll look for the other one. And within a matter of seconds, you should hear connected. Now, I don't happen to have another Sync 40 here with me. So you won't hear it say successfully paired to the other Sync 40. But that's all you need to do to make sure that you're using two Sync 40s in the same room. Next question comes to us from Amazon about Zoom. When using Zoom, does the mute sync with the PC? Short answer, yes. Can you accept hang up calls from Zoom? All right, so let's break that down. So first question, yes, it does sync up with your mute on Zoom. So you just have to press the mute button, which is located right down here, and you will see a red bar go across, and that will mute the audio. Now, when you're talking about answering and disconnecting, what you're talking about is called call controls. And as of this taping, the Sync 40 does not have what's called Zoom certification, which is what you're looking for, the answering and hanging up. And in order for the Poly to do that, it needs to also use the Poly Lens app with the Zoom app. So now, as of this taping, the Sync 40 doesn't have that integration, so you'll need to hang up and disconnect from the Zoom app versus the Sync 40. You'll want to go ahead and launch your Zoom app. And in Zoom, there's a sprocket on the upper right-hand corner, and that'll launch your settings. Under settings, you'll want to go to audio. And in audio, there should be two things that you'll want to enable. The speaker, and you can test that. And right now, it's connected to PolySync 40. And you should hear some tones, what sound like an electronic. And that way you know you're connected. And under the microphone, as you can see, the PolySync 40 is not selected. So you'll want to make sure that is selected so people can actually hear you. And there it is, PolySync 40. And you can also test the microphone on that. And look at that, I still didn't select it. There we go, Sync 40, there we go. And right now you see that there is no audio going through because I actually have it muted. So I'm going to unmute the mic. And 1, 2, 3, there you go. As you could see, the indicator shows you've got audio going through the PolySync 40. All right. I like to leave these settings as is, but if you want to go ahead and enable some additional settings, there are some additional settings for background noise suppression. You'll want to play around with these and see what works best for you. That's the best way to go about it because there's no universal setting for every single person on the planet. So go ahead and feel free to play around with that. The other piece in here is these high fidelity types of option. If you're going to be streaming music or you want your original sound instead of the enhanced sound that's provided by Zoom, you'll want to go ahead and enable some of these things. I always, for me, because I have enough bandwidth, I enable some of these things. But if you happen to be using your Sync 40 in a location where you have bandwidth constraints, you may want to just steer clear of this. Your PolySync 40 is ready to work with your Zoom application. And there you have it, a look at the PolySync 40 and some of the top questions submitted about this speakerphone. Be sure to check out our first video on the PolySync 40, where we unbox and compare it to the Sync 20, as well as answer other questions. Be sure to bump that like button so we can bring you more of this type of content. And if you have questions or comments for future episodes, go ahead and drop us a line and let us know what you'd like to see, and maybe we'll feature it in an upcoming segment. Be sure to check out the next video on the PolySync 40, as well as a playlist of several tutorials on the PolySync family. I'll see you in the next video.